When we developed our complexity framework between 2007 and 2009, we started doing a literature study on complexity models in general. To our surprise, the majority of the models found at that time were simply adding up several indicators of complexity. To give an example, a project with many stakeholders and known technology would score equally complex as a project with an innovative technology and a limited amount of stakeholders. We see things differently. But mainly one-dimensional measures were used. So, although there was quite some attention for project complexity in literature, we could not find a solid framework, originating from both theory and practice, that fully appreciated the richness of project complexity of, specifically, large engineering projects. That's why we decided to develop a complexity framework ourselves. First, we gathered as much as possible potential elements, both from detailed literature study and numerous interviews with practitioners. After careful consideration, we included 47 of the found elements in our complexity framework, consisting of two layers. The first layer is formed by the three dimensions that we distinguish: technical, organizational, and external complexity. The second layer is formed by the 47 elements that are each assigned to either the T, the O, or the E dimension. The final list of 47 elements was validated in two subsequent studies involving more than 100 projects. Let's first look where our first layer comes from. Projects are socio-technical systems in which there's an interplay of technical aspects and their impact on society. In the distinction of the T, O, and E categories, in fact, a systems perspective and an actor perspective can be recognized. The systems perspective is recognized particularly in the technical dimension and the actor perspective in the organizational and external dimensions. Although these perspectives seem really different, and in fact they are, we strongly suggest using them alongside each other in order to grasp complexity from all areas. The elements in each of the three dimensions were gathered by interviews with practitioners in the process industry, project managers, as well as team members and owner representatives. In total, 18 interviews were performed, and in the analysis, after 14 interviews, no new elements were captured, indicating data saturation. Elements were included in our final framework if we gathered evidence from both theory and practice, or if this was not the case, if either theoretical evidence or the practical evidence was coming from at least three sources. As said before, the framework that was constructed was subsequently evaluated with data from more than 100 projects in different industries. And this is how the framework looks like. As you can see, the elements in the T dimension cover goal-related elements, scope-related elements, task-related elements, etc., mainly content-focused. The elements in the O dimension cover items related to experience, trust, project team composition, resources in general, etc., mainly related with organizational aspects within the broader project team. The elements in the E dimension cover the relations with external stakeholders, market conditions, politics, etc., mainly elements related to the context the project is performed in. We will certainly not claim that our framework, published back in 2011, is the one and only way of characterizing project complexity. But it is effective and it helps increasing awareness. Extensive literature study in 2016 revealed numerous frameworks and papers about project complexity models. Comparing these frameworks with ours showed that there are two main streams underlying the frameworks. On the one hand, the stream where complexity is seen as a descriptive property of a system. And on the other hand, the stream where complexity is seen as being subjective by nature. Our framework belongs to this second stream. We are not strictly adopting a systems approach, although we surely admit that project management does benefit from a systems approach. Let's now go back to the 2x2 model of Hertog and Westerveld. They distinguish detail and dynamic complexity, with detail complexity being characterized by a high number of components with a high degree of interrelatedness, and dynamic complexity being characterized by the potential to evolve over time and the limited understanding and predictability. In fact, they state that only when uncertainties are involved, One could speak of real complexity, because this complexity cannot be simply decomposed. Mapping the elements of our TOE framework to the detailed dynamic dimensions is an exercise that can be helpful in determining which approach would be effective to manage the specific complexity. When doing this, you will notice that where the TOE elements fit the detailed dynamic complexity framework is very much dependent on the context. In one project, an element like the number of stakeholders might be placed into the detailed complexity area, whereas in another project, the same element could be placed into the dynamic complexity area, or the combination of both. This is no exact science, it just depends. Let's look at some research results to see if there are any complexity elements that seem more prominent than others. In various researches in different sectors, process industry, construction industry, ICT, and high-tech product development, we investigated complexity faced in contemporary projects. We found several similarities in the top lists of complexity-causing elements. A high project schedule drive was mentioned in all sectors, and the variety of external stakeholders' perspectives in all sectors but the high-tech industry. Several elements were mentioned in two sectors, like uncertainties in scope, dependencies between tasks, involvement of different disciplines, a lack of resources and available skills, interfaces between different disciplines, interference with existing projects, and political influence. And quite some of these elements were shown to have a direct relation to project performance. So there's something to win here, when we're able to recognize them early in the project, and if we learn ways how to deal with them.